Hey students, welcome back to the class of marketing management. In this unit, recent trends in marketing will be discussed. So those which are specified in the course, so there are rural marketing and digital marketing and consumer relationship management. So first we will discuss rural marketing. So before understanding rural marketing, we need to understand what is rural. How would we define rural or rural area? What is rural? So according to Indian system, any inhabitation with population density of less than 400 individuals per square kilometer and the 75% of male working population is engaged in agriculture or related activities and there exists no municipality or board. So if these conditions are fulfilled, the area can be defined as rural area, means low population density, less than 400 individuals per square kilometer. If most of the male working population, means more than 75% male working population, is engaged in agriculture and related activities, the area can be defined as rural. Or there exists no municipality or board. If municipality is not there or municipal board is not there, the area can be defined as rural area according to Indian system. So what is constituted as, what can be said as rural market? So this metric show that if the products are either being consumed or being produced in rural area, that would be a part of rural markets. Only those activities, only those functions or products which are produced as well as consumed in urban areas are not a part of rural markets. Otherwise, anything else where anything rural is included is a part of rural market. So products either being produced or being consumed in rural areas, or both being produced as well as consumed in rural areas, it would be a part of rural market. There are four quadrants of this matrix. So one is being produced in rural areas and consumed in urban area. Agri produce, raw materials, art and handicraft, these items are produced in rural areas and consumed in urban areas. These are a part of rural market. Post the rural production as well as rural consumption, farm and non-farm goods and services being produced in rural areas as well as being consumed in rural areas, a part of rural market. Branded consumables and durables, these are being produced in urban areas and consumed in rural areas. These are also a part of rural market. So the scope of rural market is huge. And why we need to understand or study rural market? Actually, the marketers see that there is a huge potential in rural markets. In urban markets, saturation level is almost achieved. People are using almost all the products. The growth would be achieved through either switching of the brands or growth in population would add some growth in urban markets. But in rural areas, many products are there for which the awareness is not there, or the products are not available, or the infrastructure is not available for using the product. So if the marketers create awareness, marketers make product available in the rural markets, there is a huge potential for marketers in rural markets. Just infrastructure is one thing where the marketers don't have much options, but still the marketers are doing great job by innovating some new products. Those are specifically designed and manufactured understanding, considering the needs of rural markets. So even if the infrastructure is not available, there are some products that are, or that can, there are some products that have been developed that can be used in rural areas in absence of infrastructure. Some of the examples are there, some of the examples that I would discuss are, for example, if floor in rural areas or rural households is not pakka floor, so that is not plain, that is not similar, that is not a platform, then the LPG cylinders, they are not stable on that floor. So the marketers have designed some LPG cylinders which have a broad base so that they are more stable on not so uniform floor. Similarly, there are products, there are torches being manufactured that can be recharged just by shaking. There are some transistors that have been designed for rural markets that can be, that don't use cells or batteries, that can be just recharged by twisting a knob, just like chabi ghumane se, right? So marketers have been are still designing many products, new products that understand the needs of rural areas, rural markets, and marketers are doing a great job in this way. So what are the constitutions of rural markets? Just like urban markets, rural markets can also be classified into consumer markets, institutional markets, and services markets, but the products might be different. So consumer markets are the markets where individuals buy products for self and family consumption. So many products are purchased by households for self and family consumption, like FMCG, soap, oil, shampoo, toothbrush, toothpaste, and so on. Institutional markets are the markets where the products are produced by, where the products are purchased by the businesses for use in their business. So what type of businesses are there in rural areas? Those are agriculture and allied activities, poultry industry, fishing industry, other cottage industries, and schools. So these are the industries in rural areas. So products, those are manufactured for these industries, are the institutional market product for rural markets. The for agriculture and allied, there are tractors, threshers, harvesters, pump sets, pump set oils, seeds, fertilizers, pesticides. These are the products that are specifically marketed in rural areas for agriculture and allied activities. Then there are products for poultry related activities, industry. Those are also marketed in rural areas, fishing industry related products, other cottage industry product, and schools are there in rural areas as well as urban areas. But still, that is a market for marketers of institutional product. And there are services as well. Services are also required by businesses as well as by consumers in rural areas. Services like banking, services like insurance, health services. So all these services are required in rural areas. So consumers as well as businesses buy these services from marketers in rural areas. That's all for this lecture. Thank you.